Thank you so much. So beautiful, and I love how you can see the sanctuary in the piano. There's a great reflection that's just lovely. So you feel, I don't know, the music was surrounding me, and the sanctuary was surrounding me. That was beautiful. Thank you so much. So welcome everyone to the United Church of Strafford, Vermont, on this third Sunday in Lent and Faith Sunday. The faith in the Spirit that Lent asks us to have leads through struggles and miracles. A burning bush, waters parting or springing from a rock, the voice of God, the Spirit coming like a dove whose wings carry us in unexpected directions. A story by George MacDonald tells of a young princess who gets lost in her palace and ends up meeting her great-great-great-great-great-great-grandmother, who's this loving spirit up high up in a tower. Goblins under the mountains, under the mountain where the palace is, want to kidnap the princess. So the old woman gives the princess a magic ring. If the princess gets in danger, she can put it on and she can feel for an invisible thread that will lead her to safety. Well, one night the princess hears terrifying sounds, but instead of leading her up, the thread leads down into the goblin realm, and it guides her to free a boy who was captured there. And then finally, it leads them both out to safety, out of the mountain, and then up to the tower. But the boy cannot feel the thread, and he cannot see the woman. So he thanks the princess, but he refuses to share her faith in the source of her guidance. The path of faith is both difficult and the best way through difficulties, because it is the path of the Spirit that created us and is helping us to evolve. But it is hard to trust, let alone follow. Lent comes along. Lent is designed to free our faith so that we can trust, so that we can follow, and so that we can use the Spirit's gifts to transform ourselves and the world around us into the realm of God on earth. So let us open ourselves to that possibility as we worship together. And Anamika and Becky will give us the introit now.
Is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. freedom, Christ has set us free. Stand firm, therefore, and do not submit again to a yoke of slavery. You who try to live rightly by following rigid religious laws have cut yourselves off from Christ. You have fallen away from grace, for the hope of those who follow Christ is that, like him, our faith and trust in the Spirit will lead us on the right path. To Christ, neither following the law nor not following the law counts for anything. The only thing that counts is faith, working through love. That was from Galatians 5. And Exodus 17, 1 through 6. From the wilderness of Sin, the whole congregation of Israelites journeyed by stages as the Lord commanded. They camped at Rephidim, but there was no water for people to drink. The people quarreled with Moses and said, "Give us water to drink." Moses said to them, "Why do you quarrel with me? Why do you test the Lord?" But the people thirsted there for water, and the people complained against Moses and said, "Why did you bring us out of Egypt to kill us and our children and livestock for thirst?" So Moses cried out to the Lord, "What shall I do with this people? They are almost ready to stone me." The Lord said to Moses, "Go on ahead of the people and take some of the elders of Israel with you. Take in your hand the staff with which you struck the Nile and go. I will be standing there in front of you on the rock of Horeb. Strike the rock and the water will come out so that people may drink." Moses did so in the sight of the elders of Israel. And then the third reading is John 7, 37 through 39. On the last day of the festival, the great day, while Jesus was standing there, he cried out, "Let anyone who is thirsty come to me, and let the one who has faith in my way drink. As the scripture has said, out of the heart of the faithful shall flow the rivers of living water." Now he said this about the Spirit, which those who had faith in his way were to receive. There endeth the reading.
We walk by faith and not by sight. Through joy and woe, through dark and light, we journey not alone, forsaken. You walk with us, our God and friend. In times of trouble, walk with us, loving God of mercy. Take our fear and sorrow, restore our souls, make us people of hope. We walk by faith and not by sight, through joy and woe, through dark and light. We journey not alone, forsaken. You walk with us, our God and friend. O faithful God, who dwell with us in the depths of our souls, there you speak your word of compassion and truth. In your word we find life. We walk with faith and not by sight, through joy and woe, through dark and light. We journey not alone, forsaken. You walk with us, our God and friend. We place our trust in you, O God. You restore our hope in us. darkest valleys you light the way. In you is our courage. We walk by faith and not by sight, through joy and woe, through dark and light. We journey not alone, forsaken. You walk with us, our God and friend. O God of peace, remain with us. Teach us your ways of truth. May we act with justice, compassion, and love. This is all you ask of us. We walk by faith and not by sight, through joy and woe, through dark and light. We journey not alone, forsaken. You walk with us, our God and friend. The storms of life shall bring us woe, yet we cling to your word. Behold, I am with you until the end. In your word we find life.
The choir was singing that plea chant hymn by Barbara Bridge, who has written many such beautiful chants. Its refrain says, we walk by faith and not by sight. Through joy and woe, through dark and light, we journey not alone, forsaken. You walk with us, our God and friend. We walk by faith and not by sight. The Franciscan spiritual teacher Richard Rohr wrote, "You will remain largely unconscious as a human being until issues come into your life that you cannot fix or control, and something challenges you at your present level of development, forcing you to expand and deepen." Trappist spiritual teacher Thomas Merton, several decades before Richard Rohr, wrote, "Prayer and love are learned in the hour when prayer becomes impossible and the heart has turned to stone. Prayer and love are learned in the hour when prayer becomes impossible and the heart has turned to stone." In order to grow, we need times when we can walk only by faith and not by sight. The Lenten theme today is faith, and next week's theme is struggle. We would not need faith if life were free of struggle. We would not need faith if we did not find ourselves in trackless wildernesses sometimes. We would not need faith if love did not lead to grief. We would not need faith if the selfish ego did not get us into trouble. If we did not need to grow beyond our old ways of being and seeing in order to meet new challenges. We would not need faith if we did not hit rock bottom and find that only a higher power could help us survive. So many people are in wildernesses in this long pandemic, suffering sickness, hopelessness, or grief. 1/3 of all Americans have lost someone to the disease, I read this week. And we all know people who are struggling. And imagine how the wilderness feels right now to a Black person whose community is receiving far fewer vaccine doses than white communities, while having far worse health because of the poverty and environmental pollution that come with systemic racism. How are they feeling? And meanwhile, rich white politicians are blatantly trying to keep Blacks from being able to vote. And even in Vermont, they feel profiled and attacked. Imagine that wilderness. Or imagine how the wilderness feels to a teenager who went on strike from school to try to save the Earth from runaway climate change. Imagine how it feels now to see more and more terrifying news stories about the worsening crisis, and far too few stories about the kind of rapid response that we need in order to survive. We can imagine one another's wildernesses, because all of us know pain. All of us have been hurt. All of us have experienced grief. All of us have felt outraged at injustice. All of us have had to find a way forward when the path was unclear and every step felt scary or impossible. We need faith at such times, and it makes all the difference where we choose to place our faith. Nor is it enough to have faith in something. We need to walk by faith the way we walk by sight. Biblical scholars point out that when Paul's letters in the New Testament talk about faith in Jesus, it could just as correctly be translated as the faith of Jesus. We need both. We need to have faith in him in order to have the faith of him and follow his way. But it is the faith of Christ that really saves us, if we choose it for ourselves. Because faith opened Jesus to the Spirit's guidance and power, which is what enabled him to find his way through a wilderness of trial and temptation. He walked by faith through his ministry of teaching, healing, and resistance to injustice, through his arrest and crucifixion. And faith led him through those struggles always to greater light. Similarly, walking by faith led Moses into the wilderness where his people were free at last, and yet then that same faith led them close to dying of thirst. And then that same faith led him to bring water from the rock. The late great Zulu singer and founder of Ladysmith Black Mambazo, Joseph Shabala, took a trip from South Africa to New York City in the 1980s. He entered a wilderness of loneliness, grief, and fear, a stranger in a strange land, and he was missing his family, missing his homeland, feeling the pain of his people under apartheid now that he was stepping out of it, and not knowing if he would be able to return. His courage to take that trip was walking by faith. And while there, it was faith and not sight that led him to write one of his most moving songs, Tula Klizeo. Be still, my heart. Even here, I am at home. The beautiful thing is that when we choose to place our faith in the Spirit, when we choose the faith of Moses and Jesus, or the faith of our mothers or grandmothers who first taught many of us what faith is, when we turn to that faith in the middle of a barren landscape where we feel lost and alienated and hopeless, the act of faith changes everything in that moment. Maybe it lasts only the briefest of seconds, but faith transforms the wilderness, and we see that we are at home. We see that we are walking in the promised land. We see it by faith. Faith is the sight that shows us the next step forward in love. And as Paul said, that is all that matters. Faith working through love. We do not need to know where or when this wilderness will end. We do not need to know how to transform ourselves or how to solve the overwhelming problems we face. We need only that next step of love. We need only to turn and surrender everything that we might rely on instead and let go into faith in the Spirit in this moment, for this one breath, and let it lead us on in love. So let us do this now as we pray in silence, turning in faith to the Spirit in complete trust, open and willing to be led. Let us pray. Amen. We are closing the services of Lent with a ritual, dropping stones into a bowl of water. The six stones that we are using during Lent represent the Lenten themes of spirit, freedom, and faith, and struggle, truth, and oneness. And if you have prepared your own bowl, which I invite you to do, there are still, if you haven't today, there are still Sundays left to bring a bowl and six stones. I invite you to have it near and to hold it up where we can see it when we're putting the stones in, or now to just to show it to us. Lent is about faith. It is about choosing where to place our faith. It is about choosing to act according to the faith we choose. Lent asks us to choose the faith of Jesus, who followed the Spirit into the wilderness, who broke free of his old self and trusted God to reveal each step into the unknown. Lent asks us to have the faith of Moses, who trusted in God and water flowed from the rock. Lent asks us to have faith in what Jesus and Moses had faith in, the spirit of the universe, the sacred way of all nature, so that we become the rock that the Spirit's living water flows through. William Sloane Coffin said, "I love the recklessness of faith. First you leap, and then you grow wings." So let us choose to let go and trust we will grow the Spirit's wings that can carry us through this wilderness and transform the earth into the promised land. So we will drop, we drop this stone into this bowl of water as we open our hearts to the Spirit stone. And we drop this stone for the freedom from all that enslaves us. And we drop this stone of faith into the living water so that we may keep walking by faith on our wilderness journey. Now we will close together by saying the Lord's Prayer.